He enjoys golf, portrait scenes, and he has a large collection of ties. Performing comedy, and I might have seen his class, but I hope you give him a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Andrew Goettman.
Mr. G will do fine. It's actually spelled G-O-E-T-T-M-A-N. And you can imagine how many different ways that I get to hear that murdered. Mr. Goettman, Mr. Goettman, Mr. Goettman. You know, 10 years ago, before we all walked around with a phone on our hip, they had wall phones. And my teenage son answered the phone one time, and they were asking for Mr. Getter Otterman. Where did that? I'm sorry, you just met, he just died last week. Freak blimp accident. You know, you should have called last week. Yeah, all right. Anyway, hello baby, daddy's home. I used to be a broadcaster before I was a teacher. Spent 10 years doing that, had a blast doing it, except for the Virginia Pork Festival when they stuck me broadcasting live next to the Chitlins booth. Now that was not fun. But the rest of it I loved. The only problem was is that you go broke doing that. 10 years and I was still eligible for food stamps. So, you know, I decided I'd go where the money was. I'm gonna become a teacher. Yeah, right. You see how that worked out. Now I went back to school at ECU and got my teaching certification. And it was easier for me, you know, I don't know, maybe my brain was on vacation during all of this time, but I decided that I was going to live in the dorm at ECU as a 32-year-old. Surrounded by a bunch of 19-year-old guys, their idea of a good time was going across the street to downtown Greenville, getting as plastered as possible, and praying to God that they make it back to their dorm room in one piece, and preferably with all of the same clothing that they had on. And so, you know, I'm staying in this dorm for like 2 years like this. And I will never forget one time. You know, the cafeteria food there, you know, cafeterias are generally wonderful, except when it comes to seafood. You know, they have their stuff out for like 3, 4, and 5 hours. And dummy me, the clam strips look really good at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, you know? And so by 6 or 7 o'clock, I'm in my room all covered up and just shivering and sweating and all this kind of stuff. And suddenly my stomach starts hurting. And I get up and I do some Pepto-Bismol and I realize, nope, that's coming right back up. And so I'm making a run down the hallway. Now this is a classic dorm, you know, long hallway. Bathrooms in the middle. And so I'm there and I'm hugging over the porcelain goddess, you know? And I could hear some noises out in the hall. They had the doorway that, you know, you could hear everything that's going on. And so I could hear some voices out there, which was not terribly unusual. They all kind of hung out in the hallway and talked and whatever else. And so, you know, when you're done with that, you're kind of over the sink and kind of cleaning yourself up and really trying to make sure that nobody knows what just happened, even though they can hear it through the door. And what I did not realize was that outside of that door, every single male on that floor was gathered outside of that door because they could hear everything that was going on. And they had done a head count. They figured out there are only 2 people missing. There's me. Now understand, if I'm 32 and they're 19, yeah, they called me dad. And then there was one other guy on the other end of the hall, and both of us were unaccounted for. So when I open the door, and there's every last one of them, they're all just like, dad, oh man! And next thing I know, I see money changing hands. Okay, but anyway. So, you know, I go on to become a teacher, and one of the things I like to do is to, you know, have a conversation piece. You know, she mentioned that I have a lot of ties. You don't want to know how many ties I have. You really don't. I have figured that a person could show up as a freshman, and I could wear a different tie every day all the way through their senior year and never repeat myself. So, anyway, this past week we had Halloween. And I kept telling my kids, you know, I've got the scariest tie And they're like, what is this? Freddy Krueger, Tasmanian devil, and some spooks? I said, no, no, no. This is scary on a different level. And so when I wore it, there was a repeating pattern across it that said, I'm too sexy for my tie. But that wasn't enough. You had to have the voice. I'm too sexy for my tie. Too sexy for my tie. And they're like, no, 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 I got lunch next. Stop that, please. It got worse because later that afternoon, we had early release. All the kids went home and we had professional development. And I'm sitting there with Mr. Daniels doing professional development. And we finish and I'm kind of getting my stuff together and look up. There is our beloved superintendent, Dr. Renfro. And he's just kind of spot checking, you know, the different professional developments going on. And, you know, I'm kind of hanging out because he recognized me and I figure, all right, I'm not going to run away. And he looks up and suddenly realizes a room of 50 people just became 8. And he's, oh, no, 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 everybody together. I got to have a picture for my Twitter account. So there I figure, all right, I'm taking one for the team here. And I'm standing next to Mr. Daniels, and I get home and I'm sort of telling the wife, you know, Mrs. G, that I'm gonna be on the superintendent's Twitter account this afternoon. She said, you were wearing the tie, weren't you? So I have never been to a Twitter account so fast in all of my life. To pull up that picture, blow it up, and thank the Lord, it pixelated to where you couldn't really read the tie. Thank the Lord for small favors. Y'all have been a great crowd. Be sure and tip the waitress. I'll be here all next week. I teach here. He writes my check.